This is Boggs Demonstration State Forest today. Although it has a long way to go until it's fully recovered, today's Boggs looks drastically different than it did just 7 years ago. That was when the Valley Fire ripped through Boggs and its surrounding communities, leaving devastation in its wake.
The Valley Fire burned approximately 99% of the total acreage of the forest. We estimate that 98% of the mature trees were killed as a result of the fire and subsequent bark beetle attacks. I'm Peter Lusinger, and I'm the forest manager for the Boggs Mountain Demonstration State Forest in the Sonoma Lake Napa Unit. I think what was very telling immediately following the fire was how fast it moved and how much heat it produced. The trees that were killed in the Valley Fire were completely scorched from the bottom all the way up through the crown of the tree, and in some cases the needles or leaves on the tree were pointed in the direction that the fire front moved through, which can be interpreted to show that, you know, there was a significant amount of heat and wind movement as the fire burned through the forest.
The Valley Fire is just one of countless examples of California's increasingly intense wildfire activity, driven in large part by the planet's changing climate. The entire western U.S. has seen striking changes in fire behavior in just the past 2 decades alone. This is a relatively new problem, and new problems demand new solutions.
Hi, I'm Dave Passavoy. I am in the Fire and Resource Assessment Program, and I'm an environmental scientist. I am one of the principal authors of the post-fire revegetation studies here at Boggs Mountain Demonstration State Forest. The post-fire situation was a perfect blank canvas to start a research project that examined how the forest recovers with different treatments over time. This study is going to show the landowner the different risks and hazards associated with the different choices they make for how they reforest their land. This study has 4 methods for manipulating or not manipulating the landscape. We are monitoring these areas over time, and importantly, we are comparing them to control areas that were not harvested or replanted. This will help answer questions like, how do the treatments affect vegetation, wildlife habitat, hydrology, and other aspects of the forest? How much stored carbon was lost in the fire? And how quickly does the forest recover under these different approaches?
In light of the planet's changing climate, and by extension, California's changing fire behavior, the post-fire revegetation study will help arm landowners with information to help rebuild destroyed landscapes into a healthier, more resilient forest.
Fire activity that we've seen throughout the state since the Valley Fire in 2015, there are more small to medium-sized landowners than ever before who need to do reforestation and restoration work on their properties.
If we don't figure out how to grow trees quickly and efficiently, and most importantly, protected from another disturbance, whether it be fire or drought or insect outbreak, we will continue to lose our major source of carbon sequestration and carbon storage on the landscape.
And the post-fire revegetation study is just one of many studies being conducted throughout the state to combat climate change, keep forests as forests, and ultimately create a healthier, more resilient landscape throughout California, all made possible by Cal Fire's Demonstration State Forests.
These properties in the Demonstration State Forest program are really intended to be living laboratories where we can engage in research and active forest management that can guide the practices of other landowners. It makes me proud to be able to say that we can guide those practices for other people and have a more successful and resilient forest throughout the state.